Welcome to Clinton, Oklahoma. We're getting ready to get started here. The Clinton Lady Reds and the Elk City Elkettes. Jay White, Dylan Satilla here. Big Elk TV.
Hey, Jay.
How are you, man?
I'm good.
Beautiful day?
Yeah.
Got a nice southwest wind blowing right here at our backs, blowing straight out center field.
Ooh, that could be good.
Yeah.
Could be bad. Clinton's got a lot of hitters. Or yep. I know they have three or four that can really hit.
Yeah.
And they have a tough pitcher that, you know, when she's on, she's tough. She took cash to extra innings.
Really?
Yeah.
I think they've been in a lot of ball games. They, you know, just come up short a couple of times. But
yeah, what I've heard is they'll have just a bad inning here or there, you know, that's kind of lost them a few ball games. But at home, I think this is
going to be tough. We got to get things changed up. We've had a couple of really tough ball games where we hadn't scored any runs, and so we definitely need to get the bats changed around here before playoff time starts.
Yeah.
Or if we don't do something here pretty quick, we're going to find ourselves out of the playoffs.
You can make lineup changes. You can make moves in the lineup. You know, but the most important part that the girls need to understand is they need to go get some extra cuts in on their own. Quality, good cuts. You know, when you're practicing with 20 to 25 girls, sometimes your focus may not be there, you know, to get the quality cuts that you need. So you may have to go off and do them on your own.
Well, we're sitting up here in the press box with windows, so we're not going to be hearing the crowds today, but we do have air conditioning.
Yeah, which is nice. there's a cool little breeze in the air, but
it's not horrible today, about 88 degrees, but 84, somewhere in there, I don't know.
Yeah.
It's warming up, but it's a beautiful day.
Oh, yeah. So have that fall chill or something, you know.
All right, we're getting started. Ella Satilli leading off. First pitch, hit. Over to shortstop, one pitch, one out.
Not a bad approach. You know, could have been in the gap. Number 11, shortstop, Kenzie Davis. She's a good ball player. She's played a lot of travel. I know her dad.
No. Off the – just a little number off, two pitches, two outs.
Yeah. I didn't know that pitch was a little outside, and Riley was just a little early. Got it off the end of the bat.
Seems like we're a little anxious to get something rolling today.
Maybe that's okay. Maybe that's a good thing.
Looks like low, ball one. Abby Joe batting, and
I like her approach here. She looks good in her stance. Ooh.
Called strike on the outside there. A little wide from our angle
here. Looked like chalk to me, but hey.
Another little bouncer to third.
Ooh, almost trouble.
Yep.
Well, what is that, about six pitches?
Yeah, well, I don't even know if it was that. It was one, two, three, four. Five pitches. Maybe we need to go to a break and be back here in a minute.
Yeah.
Once in a while, you find a company that operates on excellence. They hire people who are serious about safety and quality. It continues with the equipment they use, dependable, sturdy, safe. Then there's the way the companies run, with clear expectations, high standards, and fairness for employees, and commitment to delivering the very best for customers. Anadarko Dozer and Trucking is one of those companies. Anadarko Dozer is dedicated to excellence. To become one of the crew, visit AnadarkoDozer.com.
Welcome back. Jay White, Dylan Satilli. We are in the bottom of one. Clinton threw us a total of five pitches for three outs. So all little ground balls to short, pitcher, and third.
That's what you want as a pitcher.
Yep.
Imagine their coach is ecstatic after that.
Yeah. They start off with Calc, Litke, and Davis as their top three.
That's a pretty tough lineup.
Yeah, starting out.
Yeah, I think Calc, I'm not sure, but I think she's one of their power hitters, and they got her leading off. She may just be a good, solid contact hitter.
Aubrey Pogue in the circle, Abijo behind the plate. Good pitch by Aubrey. Got Calc swinging for strike one.
Looked almost like an off-speed up here.
A little high, ball one. Pretty much same lineup for the Elkettes. Pogue pitching, Abijo behind the plate. Another high. Two balls, one strike.
Yeah, I don't see any changes.
Brenda Butler, Riley White at second, Ella Satilli at short, and Emily Lawrence at third. Jada Kimball in left, Madison Holiday in center, and Jill Metter in right. That one fouled back for second strike.
Man, she took a big swing at that.
2-2's a count to the batter.
Mm. Ooh.
That was close to getting away from Madison. Outline drive there, center, short center field.
Took a little bounce and a spin.
Yep.
She had to bare hand it.
Calc with or Clinton with their first base runner.
I think we just stay, if we can stay solid and get through these first three or four hitters, that we'll be in good shape, you know, just. Let's continue to go at them.
Yep.
Get deep.
Play defense.
Yep. Play defense.
Bun. Emily Lawrence giving chase. Good hustle there by Elo. Fouled bunt.
By the time this ball hit to the by the time it's bunted, Emily Lawrence is almost all the way to the batter.
Yep.
She's like, oh, she was crashing over my head. I got to go over there.
Crashing hard. They're expecting the same thing here. Fouled off again.
There we go.
Got ahead of the batter here, 0-2.
Yeah, that's what we need. Stay ahead, stay ahead, stay ahead.
Litke's the batter for Clinton. A little high. A lot high.
Well, it's a good, pitch. I mean, get her to chase something up there. Change the eye level.
There's a hard hit ball. Jada going to get under it. No. Makes it to the fence. For a double. Just like that. No outs and two base runners for Clinton.
Yeah, I think Pogue wants that pitch back. She didn't. I don't think it was supposed to be off the plate or outside, and then she just kind of left it hanging over the middle. Good job by the hitter. Recognizing that. And
shortstop Davis up. Kenzie Davis. Got her swinging. Strike one.
You know, that was a good pitch. Change up in the dirt when you got a hitter that's
aggressive.
Yeah, aggressive with no outs. Elo came up to respect the bunt here.
Outside, ball one. They put a courtesy runner in for Calc. It's Begay. There's that bunt. Oh, my gosh. Now we're going to slipped out of her hands, and now we're going to get – she was slid in under Aubrey. We're not with it already. And just like that, Clinton will be up 2-0.
Well, from in here, I can't hear the communication between the players, but that's something you got to communicate.
Well, they were saying
home,
yes. She was right next to Elo. She's got to.
Yeah, somebody's got to let her know.
Well, at the very most, you got to check her.
That's true.
Look that runner back. Not excited, Dylan, about the way we got started here.
Well, I had a feeling in my gut that we might play like this today after, you know, getting our heads down from losing some tough games.
Right.
Playing some tough teams.
A little high there for ball two.
Elkheads need to figure out how to get their swag back.
Yep. This is Giblet, the four hole.
And the third baseman.
Still no outs.
Yeah.
Emily reached for her, but she had the ball in her, not in her glove. Did you see that?
No.
Yeah. She reached for her, and the ball was in her throwing hand.
Good pitch.
Good pitch, called strike.
It crossed the plate. I just didn't know if it was high or low.
Three balls, one strike. It's hard for us to tell up here. Right, we're right on top of the home plate.
Yeah, we got a pretty good eye of in or out.
Yeah.
That one was in.
Yep. Walked the batter.
Now we got a first and third situation. Here we go. Everybody's got a play. My guess is she's going third, but taking third, she's going to stay right on the base. So on this, on your first and third, I think it, no matter what, even if you're going to second or not, or if you're going to your second baseman to cut it.
Right.
There we go.
There's a bunt. Yeah, look back. Good job. Bunt popped up. BB's there for the first out.
There we go. That you'll need a decoy at all times, so your second baseman, if she's not covering, could always come in.
Right.
And your shortstop could go cover, you know.
Oh, on second?
On second. Yeah, you always have to have a decoy. You know, whether you come up with your shortstop or you come in with your second baseman. Got her.
Got her.
Good play.
Oh, got her. They called her out. Good play there.
Yep.
Abby Joe. Runner was a little slow. Davis was a little slow getting back.
She was not expecting that. Yeah.
Yeah. Thought we were going second and went straight to third. Swing for a strike there. Feel pretty fortunate to get out of this with just two runs if the way things were starting out there. One ball, two strikes. Cisneros is the batter. There's one hit to the gap. Another run in. Held her up, they RBI there, hit right dead to the gap. Murray's going to come out. We're going to take a break and talk about some of our sponsors. If I can find the sheet right here. Snap-on Tools, Levi Cook. Snap-on makes work easier for professionals. Barber Dyson Ford, Bruce Barber, David Corbin Dyson. Experience the difference. Anadarko Dozer and Trucking, Anadarko Leading Dirt and Trucking Company, Tips Agency, Justin Twyman, the service you deserve from your insurance agent. Murray's having a little chat with Aubrey. Not sure He didn't seem.
I think she's just leaving some balls hanging.
Right.
Or maybe there's some miscommunication with the play calls or with the pitch calls. So
right.
Hopefully they can get it straightened out.
This is Meacham, the batter. Swinging high for ball one, or strike one, I'm sorry.
Yeah, she's one of those hitters that when she hits it, she can hit it a long ways.
Fouled back. Quickly ahead here. Oh and two to the batter. Two outs. Fouled another one off.
We need to change speeds and get it off the plate here. 0-2.
That's going to be foul territory.
See, that one, that pitch ended up inside, and I don't think it was supposed to be there.
Seem not to be starting off very sharp. For sure. There's another inside pitch. Got her swinging for the final strike. And we will come back. Top of second. Elk City finds themselves down 3-0.
Barber Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Quint Nichols is from Elk City, a graduate of Elk City. You got Chris Coy. He is Elk City born and bred. Ray Haven is from Cheyenne, so he is a Western Oklahoma guy, of course. Kirby McBroom, Elk City guy. Of course, my dad, David Dyson, Elk City. Ed Stewart, who is our sales manager, is from Clinton.
Barber Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Welcome back. Jay White, Dylan Satilli here in Clinton, Oklahoma. Elk City Elkettes and the Clinton Lady Red Tornadoes.
Well, that first inning there is a little rough, wouldn't you say?
Yeah, my.
Those balls were just hitting gaps.
Yep. Everyone they hit was right between left and center and
yeah.
Got to the wall. And not like our stop three that hit little dinkers to the pitcher and
right.
Shortstop and third.
Yeah.
Definitely need to change the mentality or I don't know what, just the mojo or get the swag back or just kind of walking dead almost. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's hard to tell up here a little bit. You don't hear the chatter or the talking, but just looking at body language and those sorts of things. What do you think, Dylan?
Could be. It's hard to read teenagers sometimes.
Aubrey Pogue, the batter, 4-0 for Elk City. There's a good hard hit to the gap. Going to go the fence.
Get her up two.
Stand up double for Aubrey. Good way to start right there.
I like it.
Yeah, Aubrey's kind of been in a hitting slump.
And, yeah.
It's nice to see her get herself out of one there,
right.
Help herself out.
Yep. Are we not running, you doing a courtesy for the pitcher today?
Well, I don't know.
Called strike on Brianna Butler.
Maybe a situation where he wants to save those two girls that he runs and get them in the game. I mean, you know.
You're right.
Because if you courtesy run, you burn them, right?
I don't think so.
Oh.
Swinging at a low ball there. Strike two. 0-2 to Brianna. Way outside. Good job by Brianna laying off that.
Yeah, it's a risky move leaving her out there, especially with just with Baker being hurt.
Yeah.
That's a gap.
There's a gap. Going to go, Aubrey's going to score on that one. Brenda's going to be in for a double.
There we go. Nice job by the middle of our lineup.
Yep.
I guess there's just a lot of room there in that area because it seems like nobody can get to that ball when it's in that gap.
Well, I wonder if playing on the grass, everybody seems slower. Is that it?
I don't know. They're probably used to it. So.
Right.
But, yeah, I mean, could be it.
Jada Kimball, the batter.
That was a good eye, Jada. That was a ball all day.
Called a strike.
This is the Weatherford umpire, the one that we have when we're always in Weatherford. Here we go, get there, BB.
Yep. Pass ball off the catcher's glove. BB is able to advance to third.
She was zooming, man.
She can run. She's a lot. Yeah. She's a lot faster than people think.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Yeah, she runs hard.
She got good speed. And she, like you said, she gives a lot of effort. There's a hit by Jada.
Yep. There we go. Gets two, Jada.
Gets away from the catcher. They go home with it and gets away.
And we're right back in the game.
Right.
Okay, so this is what I was
talking about.
Yeah.
Well, that was not a good throw home in the dirt.
No.
And
It was a late decision, too. Yeah. It should have been made quicker.
We got a Jarrah's in batting.
She'd be hitting for Elo?
Yes. No.
Elo's in.
I guess hitting for Jill.
Okay. There we go.
I got through. Jada's going to score. Ball in the way of the catcher, and now Jarrah's on third. Just like that, Elk City's brought it back.
Catcher
middle of the lineup.
Catcher Meacham's having a hard time bringing in the balls.
Yes.
Nope, we got a timeout.
Moxie Realty. Moxie, make it happen. Call Amy Robbins for all your needs as far as realty concerns. Appreciate Amy and all she does for not only softball but all of the sports in Elk City. She's a big sponsor of the football. See her name up on there quite a bit. Red Dirt Garage Doors, Mike Adams, the garage door nerd. Call him for all of your overhead door needs. Elk City Summer Softball League. Helping build tomorrow's softball leaders. And State Farm agent Daniel Gabarino, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
We had a chance to listen to him on the radio.
Yeah, he's doing a great job.
He knows a lot about the game, doesn't he?
Don't give him that much credit. No, he does great. He likes that river, doesn't he?
That's called
a strike on Elo there. There's a ground ball hit. Good job by Jarrah holding up.
That's just one down.
Yep.
Nobody hurt.
It's a good hard hit ball.
Yeah.
Good play by the shortstop.
Yeah. So we're at the 9-hole now.
9-hole. Madison Holiday is up. See if we can kind of change things here with the top of our lineup coming up.
Be nice to get Holiday on with
one out top of our lineup.
Yep, runners on, or Holiday just hit one out in the outfield and run all the way around the bases.
Yep. Madison reaching for a bunt attempt there. Got to pull that back, don't we, Dylan?
Yeah, Murray's letting her know about it. Good eye.
Ball two. Three balls, one strike to the batter.
I'm guessing
Madison Hall.
That one was high, maybe?
It looked like it was over the plate. So
maybe outside,
she had to reach it. That one definitely outside in the ball.
That's the one he likes.
Yeah.
Likes that river. He likes that chalky river bank over there too.
Ooh. Ball four to Madison. That's close to being the same spot.
Yeah. That one could have been a little lower.
Yeah. Like, it's hard up here, it's hard to tell the height of the ball as it's coming across the plate. All right, here we are, what we talked about. See if top of our lineup can start moving a little something. There's a good hard hit way over right field. That'll go to the wall. It's going to score two runs. Madison will get in. Ella will get to third. Good job right there.
It's our triple machine right there.
Yep.
I think they're going to make a pitching change here. Go with the faster Davis.
Right.
Yeah.
I wonder if it's different control or have you seen her pitch, Dylan?
Sometimes her control is one of her bigger issues.
Right. Does have more speed, though.
Yeah. Which I didn't see a whole lot of difference there.
Right.
But it was just a different look.
The, what do they get, five pitches warming up?
I think that's the rule.
Yeah.
But this isn't really a timed event.
Right.
Well, you know, sometimes it go a little longer. That was huge right there at the top of our lineup, like we talked about, you know.
Well, it was starting from the middle, getting all the way on, you know.
Mm-hmm.
We come in there, start off with Aubrey. She got us started.
She did.
Give her credit, you know. We first three batters don't do anything, and then Aubrey comes in and gets a double, and then we're on a roll.
Now she can erase that first inning and forget all about it.
That's right. See if Riley's got anything in her bag today. Riley wide up, Abby Joe Robbins in deck.
Now we got to figure out how to, you know, catch up to this pitcher. And then, you know, maybe they got it right away. Keep that momentum going.
Right. And maybe they'll like the speed a little better.
Yeah.
You know, we were out in front of quite a bit on that first. The first three girls were out in front a bunch. Riley rips an inside pitch, foul for strike one.
Looked like Davis was throwing a screwball or something inside right there, the way she
stepped out and
stepped
threw
out,
in.
Threw in, yeah. Just a cutting fastball, who knows. But
she stepped way out to her left.
Yeah, you can see the line, which is illegal.
Riley fouls another one off.
She stepped out on that one, but not as much. She might have still been in the box a little bit, but. You know, if there was a box there.
Yeah, they don't have that drawn. They don't even call that much anymore.
No. Before too long, the pitchers will be able to do whatever they want. Take two. Oh, good eye.
Good job by Riley. That was close. He likes them on that.
I think not staying on the power line for Davis, I think that hurts her a little more than it helps her.
High and inside there. Really catching back up here, 2-2.
But it does look like she's throwing harder, you know, upper 50s, maybe low 60 every now and then.
Little it's blooper.
Trouble.
Little just enough right there. Just over third baseman for a little single. Caught it right on the handle. But it worked.
That's a Riley Wyatt base hit all day.
Scores another run, RBI. Take them there all day long, won't you?
Yeah. Heck yeah.
Do that all the way around?
Yeah.
Abby Joe Robbins.
They might make an adjustment after three or four hitters does it in a row.
Right.
Then we have to start hitting it over her head.
See if Abby can get a hold of one here. We get something called strike.
I bet Abby wants that one back. That one had scoreboard written all over it.
Right. Abby's known to take that first one.
Yeah.
High. Ball one.
Pitcher's still cutting that ball across the plate.
hit Abby on the foot and bounced up.
So that's like 8 or 9 hit by pitches?
It's a bunch. I'd have to go look here. I'd have to go back to info.
Meh.
Aubrey Pogue got us started this inning. There's another good rip.
That one's got a chance.
Over the center field. Ship falls down. Aubrey's going to be in for second. Abby Joe hustling around, blocking the plate. Good job by Aubrey right there.
No, they didn't put a runner in for Abby Joe either.
No. Elk City finally coming alive here. Great hit by Aubrey. Got it right over center fielder's head. Line drive. There's a little blooper to BB. Oh, no. Get back, Aubrey. She thought that was going to fall.
Yeah, she was a little lucky that the left fielder failed to catch that ball.
Yep.
I mean, she probably could have stayed on her feet and got her out.
Yeah. Aubrey was halfway to third.
Yeah.
I think she thought the same thing I did. That was falling, didn't you?
Maybe. I just thought maybe she's wanting to be on ESPN tonight. Make it look cooler, you know, when you dive.
Inside for ball one to Jada.
Let that get you, Jada. Nice hit.
There's a
good
rip. Jada. That one's out of here.
That's out.
Woo. Nice rip by Jada.
Right over the middle of the plate, and she got it.
Yep.
Well.
Good job by Jada. Is that her first one?
That's the first one.
Good job. Somebody get that for Jada.
Oh, the umpire's got it. Or somebody out in the field's got it. Threw it back and grabbed that, Murray.
Yep. Somebody in the Ranger sitting out there in the outfield threw that back in.
Yeah, he's got a little hill where he can kind of see everything. Man, 10 runs.
Yep.
One inning.
What we've been waiting on. Jerry Moeller is up. Two outs. That one got away from Davis.
It's good to see. It's good to see the Elkettes.
Yep, get on fire there.
Yeah, they've been
with their bats. We've been needing that little confidence. Good cut by Jara.
You know, I like this move with Jara in the lineup. I mean, she's one of those girls on the bench that we have that can hit the ball.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and there's several others.
Right.
There's a good two or three others that have been hitting the ball really well in the JV games.
Right. Good to see somebody get an opportunity.
Yeah. Yep.
When we've had some struggles. Ooh. That looked good from here, but obviously high. Two balls and one strike to Jarrah. Two outs. Big 10-run inning by the Elkettes. Nothing's outside. Ball three.
You know, these 10 runs, I mean, they rarely weren't the prettiest. But we got them.
Yeah. Some of them weren't. Some of them were Aubrey's hit and Jada's hit was pretty sick. Yeah. And Birdie's hit. Yep.
I mean, that's good hits.
Yeah. There's a good hard hit. Going to get through. Nope. If she's hustling down. Called out.
Just in time.
All right. After a 10-run inning, Elk City's back on where they need to be. We'll be back in a minute.
We absolutely love fulfilling the goal of the client. A home really is your biggest security, right? It's your safe place. It's where your family feels protected. It's your own space. And we love working with our clients and finding them that security space. Basically, we want to get people where they want to be, both physically and financially. I'm Amy Robbins, and my company is Moxie Realty. MoxieRealty.com.
Welcome back. Clinton, Oklahoma. Jay White, Dylan Satilli. Elkette softball versus the Clinton Lady Red Tornadoes. We had a big inning those there. Girls, we hadn't seen one of them in a long time.
Those girls proved me wrong.
Yeah.
I wasn't expecting much out of them today. And they
Aubrey got us started with a double. And, I mean, just time, you know, good hits and good places. And, yeah. Jada finished it off with that bomb to left field. That was a nice. Glad to see that for Jada. Things we're going to need going forward and a little confidence. Aubrey starts her off high. Ball one.
We got here Starnes. The left fielder. No.
Mm-hmm.
Center fielder. No. What's she play? She's a center fielder.
Yes, be there. 8-0. Swinging. Strike one. Two balls and one strike to Starnes. Fouled back for a second strike.
Got a lot of ball this week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Doubleheader tomorrow night.
And that's with Leedy and
Snyder. Got her swinging strike three.
Well, the first hopefully we don't have to pitch Pogue both games. I mean, neither one of those games really mean anything at all.
Right. And then Weatherford at home Thursday is a huge game.
That's the one we need to be rested up for. I think it'll go our way when we were home against Weatherford. You know,
it was a close ball game. We just had a hard time hitting that pitcher.
Yeah.
Outside ball one.
Marley Teasley, she did a great job pitching that game. Mm-hmm. That was one of the best games I've seen her pitch.
Newcomb is the batter for Clinton. 9-hole hitter, left fielder. Come right at her, Aubrey. 9-hole hitter.
Yep. Make or beat you.
That's somebody you don't want to get down to 2-0, I don't think. Could be wrong. That swinging strike. Two and one to the batter, Newcomb. Corners are up a little bit, expecting a slap or a bunt. Called strike. 2-2 to Newcomb, one out.
It's A. Newcomb. I wonder what the A stands for, Jay.
Avery.
Avery?
I don't know. Swinging.
Got her.
Got her. Yeah, I'm glad we came back after two balls.
Yep. Got to get ahead of this
one. Back to the top of Clinton's lineup. Kenzie Kalk.
I want to say the A was for almost.
There's one change up off the end of the bat.
Got her. Three up, three down, Jay.
Yep. That's what we needed.
Yep.
Come get a few more runs here. back after this word from Daniel Garbarino.
Paragon Sports welcomes State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino and his family to Elk City. And he's proud to support this area's schools, students, and their activities. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. With surprisingly great rates for auto coverage and surprisingly great rates for everyone.
For your surprisingly great rates, contact your local State Farm agent today.
If you want the real deal, call State Farm agent Daniel Garbarino in Elk City today.
Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Sweet little word there from the official sideline reporter of Big Elk TV.
Yeah, they need to make a commercial with him in it, acting out the part of Jake from State Farm.
Oh, you think?
Yeah.
Looks like the body language has changed a little bit after that inning.
Oh, yeah, Weatherford's a little...
Clinton?
Clinton. One of those towns we don't like, right? No, we like them, Jay. They're our neighbors, right?
That's right.
Supposed to love thy neighbor.
Emily Lawrence would be the batter on up, and Madison Holiday on deck. 7 hits and 14 at-bats. A little better today with 10 RBIs, 10 runs scored.
Nobody struck out, and that's huge.
Yeah, no strikeouts.
We've had a lot of strikeouts.
Everybody's
lately.
Got a hit so far but Emily, and this will be her second at-bat.
She's due. But that's a good pitch.
Yep.
It's a great spot. By number 11, Davis.
Let's go, Elo. Keep us rolling here, baby. Fouled that one back. Looked like a changeup there.
Off speed, yeah. Emily's favorite pitch.
Yeah. She didn't like the illusion. She got a piece of that one.
Yeah, she did. She was on it.
Outside. Oh, that was not.
That's the one you want.
That was outside the chalk. I'm sitting right over the top of it and saw that and come across.
That's one the umpire wants back, yeah. I'm sure. A little low, a little outside.
Tough call.
Yeah. Sometimes when you're down
sometimes
seven
when,
runs,
yeah.
The umpire will give the other team a little bit.
Well,
it happens.
That's you know, Elo with her struggles right now, you hate to
that's
see that
good.
For her.
It's not
you,
good, yeah.
You know, because that's not on her. That's a good job I heard, letting that pitch go, and then it gets called on her. I hate to see that for a kid.
Looks like Davis has got she's a little warm. She's got a little more. Ooh, that's trouble.
Oh.
Close, bang, bang.
Yep. That was a close call at first with Madison speed, but call for the second out. Back top of the lineup here. I think that's the first ball Madison's put in play in a while.
A lot of walks or strikeouts.
Yeah, well, no, she did have a walk last at bat, her first at bat. We're top of the lineup here. Ella Satilli. There's a little chopper through the gap between second and third, between third and shortstop. And Ella's on with her second hit. But we have two outs. See if we can have a little two-out rally here. Umpire's having a little conversation with the pitcher. Not sure what that's about.
I don't know if Coach Murray's having an issue with the way she – separated her hands to step off the rubber
right.
to call time, then that's what you're supposed to do.
Right.
So I don't know what the issue was.
High. Ball one to Riley. See what goes on here. There's a nice little hit. Perfect spot going to the fence. Riley's going to be in for a double. Ella's going to score.
That's a good hit.
Yep, that was a great hit.
You know, Riley's got kind of that closed stance a little bit where she's angled. Right. Well, with that girl throwing at an angle to you, it's almost like it's perfect coming up the middle instead of inside at you.
Right.
You know, so that's kind of worked out good. I mean, just right in line with the pitcher, she released it, not from where she started.
That was a good hit.
Yeah, it was a great hit. Squared it up.
Strike to Abby Joe.
We got to get Abby to hit that. That's the one she can hit a long, long ways.
Swinging. Strike two.
I wonder if Jeremy Robbins wants to come up here and talk a little bit. He usually likes to talk.
There's a ball high. One ball and two strikes to Abby Joe. 11-3, Elkett's lead. Two outs, top of the third.
Good hit.
There's a good hit. Gonna maybe fall. Nope. Center field settled under it for the third out. We'll be back after these messages.
If your garage door looks like this, there's only one person to call. Red Dirt Garage Doors. They'll literally get you back on track and rolling up and down again. Red Dirt Garage Door does residential and commercial sales and service, serving Southwest Oklahoma and the Texas Panhandle. You can call for a free estimate at 580-482-6369. That's 580-482-6369. Red Dirt Garage Doors, keeping you on track and the garage door looking good.
Welcome back. Jay White and Dylan Satilli here in Clinton, Oklahoma. Elkett's with a big lead. Bottom of the third. 11-3. Had a big, big 10-run second inning.
Managed to scratch one across with two outs. Yep. Big hit by Riley.
Are they waving at us?
They're waving at us. I think BB even blew us a kiss.
Glad to see there. Got a little giddy up in their step back.
Trying to have a little fun.
Yep. Appreciate the Clinton communications class letting us get up here in their
space.
Their space and their press box.
Hopefully they're not thinking they're going to learn something from us, right?
Yeah. Their teacher just left shaking their head going, oh, man. There's a nice pitch by Aubrey. Good change up for the second strike.
Like these two guys, they're the worst communicators in the world. I get a lot of people say they really like listening. So
they're just being nice to us, Dylan.
That's what I'm thinking.
Good pitch inside there. Been hard to get around on for a ball, though.
Lithke. Lichty?
Lithke.
Lithke.
I guess there's not an H. Lithke.
Oh.
2-2, the count. See what Aubrey's going to do here.
I was just over here talking like Mike Tyson. Oh, that's a good.
Fouled off. Aubrey kind of settling in a little bit after that first inning.
Yeah, she's in her spots, doing what she has to do.
Ooh. Fouled another one off. Count remains 2-2, no outs. No, there is an out in there.
Yeah, strikeout.
Yep, strikeout.
Wait, no.
No.
Nothing.
And in the dirt.
It's still our leadoff. Or she's a two-hole.
Yep.
Lipke.
My bad.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right.
Ooh. Had her reaching for that foul.
Ball had some movement.
3-2 pitch coming here. Oof. Abby Joe thought that was a strike.
It was a good spot.
Good spot.
Thought it painted that inside corner. Yep.
Ump's telling Murray just barely missed.
Okay.
It didn't look like it missed much up here.
He must have just barely blinked and missed it.
Yeah. Davis is a hitter. Fouled off. Big hack.
Yeah, yeah. She took a cut out on that one. I like Davis, the way she plays. She plays hard and looks a little scary with her approach and, you know, how confident she looks.
Right. A little high, ball one. Inside there, right in under the elbow.
Surely Pug's not trying to pay her back for hitting Abby Joe a while ago, huh?
I wouldn't think so.
Nah.
That was low, ball three.
We got an 8-point lead. You know, we just got to throw strikes.
Go at them. Another ball for a walk. Two walks in a row here. Don't need to give free base runners.
No.
Giblet's the batter.
Pogue just needs to do. She just needs to relax, work her mechanics, and everything else will fall. There
right
you go.
There it is.
Nice and smooth.
Yep. That was smooth, wasn't
it? Yep. Nothing seemed forced. She just took a deep breath and just did what she's been training to do for, what, 5 or 6 years now?
Or 10?
No. Well, maybe. She started pitching when she was 5?
Yeah.
Did she?
Yeah. You know how them Pogues are. Mama's serious. Good pitch. One ball and two strikes to the batter, Giblet.
Well, if Mama's listening, I just want you to know the views and opinions of Jay Wyatt does not match the views of me. I'm trying to keep myself safe. I'm scared of that lady.
Oh, scares me too. I've told her that forever. Shannon's a tough boy.
Hell yeah.
Inside, come back here. Full count. Sure like Aubrey to go at her right here.
Yep. Don't need another walk. Get your defense work. There's that big gap.
Got her.
Good pitch.
Good pitch. Aubrey, strikeout.
That for out number one?
Fourth strikeout of the day for Aubrey.
All right. Oh, a little trickery.
Yep. Abby kind of delayed back there with the –
look like she's going to go two and just kind of.
Davis kind of, you know, we got Davis on third over there earlier, not paying attention, kind of.
She's like, why is everybody trying to pick on me? There we go. Touch base, Elo. Oh, foul ball.
Foul ball. Just barely foul. Good job by Elo, making sure. Go ahead and play that. One ball, one strike. Is that right? I hadn't seen that. Umpire gives count. Oh, good change up right there. One ball, two strikes. One out. Fouled off. Way late on that.
Yep. It's a good swing with two strikes. Just looking to foul something off. So she gets one she wants.
Oh. Got her on a changeup on the outside there. Great pitch by Aubrey. Nice pitch.
Could have been on the other side of the riverbank, yep. But he's been calling it.
Yeah, no doubt. Two outs for the Clinton Lady Reds.
I thought they were tornadoes.
Lady Red Tornadoes.
But it just says Reds.
I don't make their decisions here, Dylan. That's what it says on the school board, too.
Maybe just Lady Red Tornadoes is just too long.
There's pop-up. Riley's settling underneath it and for the final out of the third inning.
Man, what a long game.
Man, this one's taking a little longer than the others. We'll be back after a word from Levi. Welcome back to Clinton. Jay White, Dylan Satilli. Thank you, Levi Cook, for sponsoring Elkette Softball Big Elk TV. Appreciate it.
So I'm guessing a tornado is gender neutral. So you got to leave it out.
Didn't the names, what were they used to be? Was that hurricanes? That's hurricanes I'm thinking of. They used to give them names of women. Now they're Ivan and.
Well, or hurricanes have La Nina years and El Nino years.
Oh, is it? We're gonna show how stupid we are, and my teachers are shaking their head. Oh. Good thing my wife doesn't listen anymore.
She's probably interested in the La Nina and El Nino.
Right.
Get to lead off with Pogue again.
Yep. We're already an hour into the game.
Wow.
We're at the top of the fourth. This one's a little slower than the few others we played. We'd be just about done. Tuttler cashed the other day.
Well, when you're not
This one a lot better.
I do too. This is what we've needed. But it's still a lot of ball game left, you know. We can have one bad inning just like they did.
I'm getting texts from my wife. She says, I am listening. And I'm shaking my head.
Whatever.
I thought maybe she'd quit listening after a while, but I guess not. Strike one to Aubrey. There's a little off the end of the bat. Oh, right underneath the glove of Davis. She kind of tried to backhand that, and I'm not sure why.
I don't think that's her usual spot, but since –
no, that's not David Davis.
Davis is pitching, so –
that would be
Cisneros.
Yes.
I remember she must have had an older brother that played basketball a few years ago. I remember us playing against somebody with that name.
Brianna Butler's at the plate. Big hack there. Fouled off for strike one.
Murray's letting her know that she pulled off a little bit, had her head flying open.
Yep.
You know, you got to keep that front side closed just a hair longer. See it just a hair longer. Drive it.
There's a little poke. Going to fall. Going to be tougher. Oh,
she's safe.
Come on. Aubrey thought that one was going to be caught.
What? I don't know.
She didn't ever leave.
Yeah, she didn't work off at all, did she?
No, she didn't work off the plate at all. I was sitting there watching her and it was like, what are you doing? I assume that she just thought it was going to be caught. Jada, who had the big bomb last time, swinging strike. Jada's 1 for 2 today.
It's
Good hit.
That's a good little hit right there over shortstop. Falls in there for a single. Moves the runners.
Good to see Jay to get hot.
Yes.
Seeing the ball.
Jerem Moeller, new in the lineup.
So far, she's done a good job.
Yeah. Jer's 1-for-2 today.
Got her an RBI.
A little late on that swing for a strike. Jarrah steps in. Low ball one, good eye.
Good eye. Not a whole lot of panic or stress in Jarrah's approach. She's just in there. Looks like she just wants to do her job.
Tough one right there.
Look a little high. Maybe on the... Did hit the outside corner from my view, but it's not one you want to take a hack at.
One ball, two strikes to Jarrah, one out. Runners on first and second. That one definitely high. 2-2 to Jarrah. I like her approach. She just, like you said, just seems even keel and doesn't get over, you know, first time in the lineup.
Yeah, she doesn't seem anxious.
Yeah.
I'm sure there are some nerves, but.
Got it back to full count. You know, sometimes you get a girl in there first time in, she's going to be swinging it, whatever, you know.
Yeah.
I've seen it happen quite often. There's a payoff pitch to Jarrah. Rips one right down the middle. Bringing Brynn on home.
It's two RBIs on the day for Moeller.
Good job. That was a good hit. Good solid contact right up the middle. Right over second base. Emily Lawrence.
Like to scratch one or two more, and we get out of here five innings if we can.
Like to see Elo really get a hit here.
Yeah, she just needs to be aggressive and see her pitch.
Fouled that first one off.
I like it. Her hands are so quick, you know. She was so far out in front of that. And it was a fast inside pitch, you know. Just her hands are so quick.
I wish she had the confidence in her that we'd have in her.
Yeah.
There's that changeup that she does not like, though. Two strikes on Emily Lawrence. Outside ball gets away from the catcher, but runners advance. One out.
Just need something on the ground, opposite side, get this runner in.
Right.
Get us that 10-run cushion that we'll need.
Let's go, Elo. Ooh.
It's low.
That looked
pretty low. It's low.
Yep. It's hard for to look up here, but it was right down the middle, wasn't it?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Popped up high right here to the pitcher. Madison Holiday is up.
Come on, Holiday.
Madison still 0-for-1 today with a walk. This will be her third at bat. Huh? ball two to Madison. Tough pitch right there. Out called strike on the outside.
Holiday toe up on that line a little bit.
Oh. Low.
Low. Good deal getting around base with birdie coming up.
Yep.
That's trouble. She's there.
Safe. Good hustle down the line right there. You got to – when she puts a slap in play, you've got to be hustling as shortstop.
You
can't bobble the ball. You can't just take an extra step. You better be going straight.
You got to go get it.
You got to go get it and fire it.
Yeah.
With our speed. Guess that did score another run.
That's sitting the run there.
Yeah, watching Madison there to make sure she got the first. I forget. Brenna got across the plate there.
Got to hit that one, birdie.
Called strike.
I don't know if maybe Holiday was supposed to steal there.
Yeah.
She was.
She was supposed to steal, and yeah. Murray's looking birdie at her like, "Where? What are you doing?"
Birdie was taken.
Yeah. Fouled off.
Now we got two strikes.
Yep. Got to know the signs. Trying to figure out what the third baseman and pitcher are talking about there. They're looking back to the umpire.
Well, I think they're just trying to make sure he's okay.
Yeah.
He got a little shot from the ball. From the
foul did
ball.
He?
Yeah.
He's below me. I can't. Outside.
Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah. Wild throw by the second baseman. Madison makes it on the third. Another run scores.
Well, that was the right play. I mean, they drew up the right play. You know, it was – a little more practice, I think they could, you know, start
making that happen.
Making that happen, yeah.
Ball got away from second baseman, ended up in between catcher and third. One ball, two strikes to Ella. Called strike, third strike there. Third out. We will be back in a moment.
Tips Insurance Agency is an independent insurance agency. Justin Twyman, what does that mean?
Well, Sean, that means that we can go out and shop multiple carriers. We're not tied to one line of business. That way, if one line of business declines you, we have another line of business to come in and quote. Tips Agency, we currently represent a little over 100 carriers. So we have an outlet for your insurance needs.
What's the best way to contact you at the Tips Agency?
You can stop by my office, 314 North Main Street, just north of Walgreens. Or you can call my cell phone. Cell phone number is 580-374-1052.
Welcome back to Clinton, Oklahoma. Jay White and Dylan Satilli. We are in the bottom of the fourth. Elk City's up big here, 14-3 over Clinton. Lady Red Tornadoes. We started off a little slow. Clinton got jumped out on us early there and got scored three runs in the bottom of the first. And after that, Elk City kind of came out with a vengeance and scored 10 runs in the second and one in the third and three in the fourth.
Yeah, they just, you know, just hadn't looked back. I'm kind of – so, okay, that one stands for 10. Oh.
Yep. Fouled off.
But that was just two innings ago. Doesn't it seem like it's been about five innings ago?
Yeah.
We're at seven, Meacham's
eight, the batter.
Yeah, 7-8-9 hole.
Mm-hmm. Hope we go at them right here.
Yeah, three up, three down.
A little low. Ball one. Oh, she wanted to go.
Mm-hmm.
A little outside there.
Well, I guess.
Been strike a lot, though. Maybe it's high.
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. This girl's about 5'10", so I doubt it. That one's low.
Yep. 3-1 to the batter. Meacham.
Standing up like this, I feel like those guys on Monday Night Football, yeah. You know?
Only problem is we don't have any suits on.
Yeah.
And we're not very good. Foul back.
Oh, I'm looking down there. I see your wife talking to my wife. She's probably telling them how Andy's probably telling them how dumb we are.
They married us. Full count. A little low. We didn't need that. Having to throw too many pitches when we do that thing right there. Go at her. Get aggressive.
No passiveness. Just go.
Starnes is the batter, center fielder for Clinton. Called strike. Way to start it. Low and outside. Ball one. Good pitch right there. Got her swinging.
That's a tough one to hit. Just low and routed her knees on the outside part of the plate.
Able to foul that one back. One and two, the count to Starnes. Got a little bat there, fill in the gap.
That's where all that grass is. Just,
yep.
Just a lot of it.
It's only a 200-foot fence. Dude. It just seems big today. Maybe it's because where we're at.
Could be.
A little adjustment here by outfield.
And you know, I see, so left field is a lot higher.
Yeah,
center field.
It slopes. It's always had a bad slope. Gets away from Abby Joe. She does a good job keeping it in front, keep the runners from going.
Yeah.
Good job by Abby right there. Ball one, low in the dirt.
She's helped us out a few times, big time back there today.
No outs. Called strike.
Get Riley over there covering one.
Pop back up. A little bunt popped up in there, and BB comes over, crosses, and does a good job for the first out.
That's the second one she's got.
Yep. Really kind of hurt. My wife still listens. Dylan.
It's like you don't think she trusts you or what?
I don't think it's because she wants to hear me. I think it's more of a trust issue.
I don't know.
Swinging foul right there. Lead off hitter.
I think Cal. I like it. If you know what I mean.
I don't.
Okay. I won't say it on the radio.
Little high, ball one. 1-1.
She's not listening now.
She gave up.
Yeah. She doesn't care if tornadoes are gender neutral or not.
No. 1-2 to the batter. Calc. Mackenzie Kalk. 14-3 lead, Elkettes. Low in there. Two balls and two strikes to Kenzie Kalk. 14-3 lead, Elkettes. We're in the bottom of the fourth. There's a good hard hit to...
She slid, so the play's not dead.
Yep.
That'll score a run.
Yep.
Sometimes the move works, sometimes it don't.
I'm not sure what Riley was doing there. I think I know, but I hope I don't.
The runner was a little late getting down, right. Maybe. She was sliding, but it was a little late, so yeah. Riley thought maybe she had that double play.
There's a hard hit to right field. Jill gets it in quick.
Got her. She's out. Well, she was out. Did she not have the ball in her glove? Or?
I don't know. Huh. I never saw a call.
And I mean, it'll kind of block the plate maybe a little bit, but I think she got the tag over.
Riley standing over here like she had her out, but.
Yeah, should have been out. Oh, he said it was obstruction.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And that's the only thing I could think of is why I wouldn't. Because she kind of had her foot there.
Yeah.
She couldn't, slide through it. Yeah.
Right. Is Davis.
Big swing by Davis.
Two outs. Davis is 0 for 1 today with a walk. There's ball there. Hit to third base. Nice little play by Elo. We'll be back.
Once in a while, you find a company that operates on excellence. They hire people who are serious about safety and quality. It continues with the equipment they use, dependable, sturdy, safe. Then there's the way the companies run, with clear expectations, high standards, and fairness for employees, and commitment to delivering the very best for customers. Anadarko Dozer and Trucking is one of those companies. Anadarko Dozer is dedicated to excellence. To become one of the crew, visit AnadarkoDozer.com.
Welcome back. Top of the fifth, Jay White, Dylan Satilli here in Clinton, Oklahoma. Elkettes lead 14-4. Clinton managed to get a run across there in that fourth inning.
Yeah.
Threatening, had runners on second and third, but good play by Elo right there. Ground ball hit right to her and up quickly and made a good throw to first.
Davis doesn't look too happy. She got thrown out on that last play.
Top of fifth. The 10 runs after 5 in district play?
I'm pretty sure. I mean, that's what I think. For some reason, I thought it was 8, and then it wasn't. So I'm guessing it's 10.
I know it's different for different in district.
Yeah.
Riley White's up to bat. Riley is
2 for 3
today.
Yeah.
2 RBIs, 1 runs across. And therefore a strike. Change up.
Just got her.
One out. Abby Joe is 0 for today, 0 for 2, hit by a pitch.
That's been kind of a calling card, just getting hit by the pitch.
Yeah, I'd like to see her get hit the bat on it.
Yeah, she almost got hit right there.
Mm-hmm. Well, she's not going to move.
She might even get in the way.
Yeah. Got called for it at Cash the other day.
Yeah.
Sticking that elbow out a little bit.
Yeah, I kind of made myself look like a fool after that. Because, I was sitting over there, and I was hollering at the umpire. Mm-hmm. Roo, 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 roo. And then after the game, Jeremy's like, yeah, man, she stuck her elbow out there.
Yeah.
I was like, oh. Oh, I feel dumb.
One ball, one strike. Tabby Joe. Got her swinging.
Chase the high one.
Yep. One ball, two strikes.
Murray's over there saying, come on, Abby Joe. Swing at a good one. I can see it.
Ooh, that was.
I mean, it was out.
It was definitely out. Definitely out, but he's been known to call that today.
Leonard staying camped out in the shade over here.
2-2. Inside, full count. Abby Joe, one out.
I want her to look for a hit. I don't want her to be passive. There it is. Good hard hit.
Good hard.
Got the shortstop on her heels a little bit.
Hard hit. That shortstop doesn't really like sticking her nose in there.
No, it is. I mean, it's hard moving Davis away from there. But I mean, she's a good pitcher, but right. she's a wonderful shortstop.
Right. Pogues up 3 for 3 today.
She'll have a
chance.
Two
runs, two RBIs.
Davis will have a chance to All-State this year. I mean, she'll definitely be an All-District player, but. She's definitely got a chance to All-State. I think she might have started all 4 years she's been out here.
Ball low to Aubrey. Ball outside. Two and 0 to Aubrey Pogue. 3 for 3 today. See if she can keep it going. Get that batting average up. There's a little inside pitch. She's not going to make it this time. Caught it on the handle. Back to the pitcher. For two outs. Moved Abby to second, though. Brenna Butler up. She's 2 for 3 today. Two runs, one RBI. Two outs. A little off-speed pitch. Off the end of the bat by Brianna for a foul.
Oof.
It's a big hack. Big, big hack. Head coming out again, though. She collects herself and get ready to step back in.
I think she's just trying to show the pitcher her avocado sticker. Look at it. Guacamole.
There's a big one.
There we go.
That's hit off the fence for a nice double.
Yeah, holding her up at 2. Good hit.
Good hit. BB. She'll be 3 for 4 today. Now Jada's up with the big bomb today. She's 2 for 3.
Calc and Davis having a conference. They've been doing this together for a while. I think they've played some travel ball together and stuff like that. Trouble. Ooh.
Picked up by the first baseman and for the third out. We'll be back to the bottom of the fifth. Word after these messages from Barbara Dyson.
Barbara Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Quint Nichols is from Elk City, a graduate of Elk City. You got Chris Coy. He is Elk City born and bred. Ray Haven is from Cheyenne, so he is a Western Oklahoma guy, of course. Kirby McBroom, Elk City guy. Of course, my dad, David Dyson, Elk City. Ed Stewart, who is our sales manager, is from Clinton.
Barbara Dyson Ford has Western Oklahoma's sales crew.
Welcome back, Clinton, Oklahoma. Jay White, Dylan Satilli. We're in the bottom of the fifth. Elk City's up 15-4. Let's see, can we get in and out of this deal with the unscathed? Who's this batter, Dylan?
This, I think, is Giblet.
Yes. The third baseman?
Yep.
33?
20, 25.
I'm not sure why they have 33 on there.
Well, it's 25 on here, okay. So. The one that matters.
I'm looking at the game changer here. One ball to Giblet. Called strike. Good pitch by Aubrey. Pitch.
Froze Giblet just a little bit. A little late reacting to it. Had to let it go by.
Inside. Ball two. There's a hard hit, Madison.
There you go, Holiday.
Come up, played that one. We've been letting those drop, and I've seen some work in practice on that. That was a good job coming up and getting that line drive.
That's good.
It had to go down to a knee, but good job by Holiday. First out of the inning. Meacham is the batter. Got her swing in there. Meacham is 0 for 2 today with a strikeout. Bottom fifth. Fouled way back.
She took a good hack on that
one. Much better swing by Meacham. 0-2 to the batter. One out. Bottom of fifth. Elk City's up 15-4. Oh, what a good job.
Good job by Elo, huh?
Yeah, I mean, that girl reached all the way across the plate. That thing was a foot over in the other batter's box. Got her bat around on it and sent it right down the third baseline. I was where she hit that from. I don't know how she got the ball there, do you?
No. Well, I know.
Two outs.
Elo made a great little play on that. Just a little backhand. She had a lot of time. Didn't think she would.
There's a base hit into left field. Good job by Jada getting it in, keeping it to a single.
Here's the other, Meacham. Now, I wonder if she's the younger sister.
Center fielder? No, the catcher, I'm sorry.
The catcher. I don't know if she's
Russ's daughters. Russ Meacham, I believe so. I know he's a big supporter of the softball over here.
Oh, yeah.
There's a high ball. Jill's underneath it in the
good
sun.
Job,
good job by Jill.
That's the ball game?
Is that the ball game? I believe it is.
Good job, Elkettes.
All right. We'll be back after a moment and go over some stats.
We absolutely love fulfilling the goal of the client. A home really is your biggest security, right? It's your safe place. It's where your family feels protected. It's your own space, and we love working with our clients and finding them that security space. Basically, we want to get people where they want to be, both physically and financially. I'm Amy Robbins, and my company is Moxie Realty. MoxieRealty.com.
Welcome back. Jay White, Dylan Satilli here in Clinton, Oklahoma, where the Elk City Elkettes won big off of the Clinton Lady Red Tornadoes. Dylan, Elk City had 15 runs on 15 hits and one error. The Lady Red Tornadoes had 4 runs, 7 hits, and 3 errors.
It was real good to see. This is a big district win, obviously.
Right.
We needed another district win.
Right.
It's good to see. Everybody had hits. Everybody's
almost
hitting the ball.
Almost.
Elo not get one?
Elo didn't, and Abby Joe didn't have a hit.
Oh.
And so Ella was 2-for-4. Riley was 2-for-4. Abby was 0-for-3, hit by a pitch. Aubrey was 3-for-4. Brenna Butler was 3-for-4. Jada Kimball was 2-for-4. Jerem Moeller came in, hit for Jill, and was 2-for-3. Great job by her. And Elo had a tough time, got a tough call on that one strikeout, you know.
Yeah.
And had a couple of balls that she hit, just hit to somebody. And then Madison was 1-for-2 today with a walk. So, 31 at-bats, 15 runs, 15 hits.
I mean, that's close to hitting 500 for the day.
Yeah,
as a team.
One walk and 2 strikeouts.
And both their pitchers, I mean, they're good pitchers. They,
right.
You know, they're not slouches.
Right. Aubrey threw more pitches than I would have liked.
Yeah. Even in a 5-inning game,
yeah.
I mean, she threw as much. 98
pitches.
Yeah.
In 5 innings, threw 98 pitches, 7 hits, 4 runs. Gave up 4 earned runs. 4 walks and 5 strikeouts. So,
it's a good outing.
I'm not disappointed. I would just have liked to have seen her go at some batters a little more, not giving up the walks.
And I'm not sure if she's still, got some nagging injuries here or there. I mean, she may.
It's not as sharp as we've seen her in some of the games. Like, I felt like Cash, she played more than well enough for us to win. We just didn't hit the ball,
Yeah.
And so
sometimes fatigue and mental fatigue, it kicks in the middle of the softball season. It's a long, long season, especially for a pitcher,
Especially when she's your only pitcher.
Yeah, I remember seeing it with Robin Bales and with Danny.
Yeah.
I mean, for 4 years, it was just
– the ups and downs.
Yeah.
But big win for the Elkettes here in Clinton. We'll be back tomorrow night there in Elk City. Y'all come out and support the girls. 5:00, a three-way with Snyder and
Leedy.
So
Leedy's been having good. I don't know anything about Snyder.
I don't either.
But Leedy's had a good season.
They're a solid team. So.
I think I saw Hammond might have beat them by 3-2, not too long ago. But Hammond, they got a great bunch right now.
We will be back. Stay with us. Come out and support us. We'll be, like I said, tomorrow, Tuesday night, we'll be in Elk City. And Thursday night, a great big district game against Weatherford. Kind of hope to avenge our first district loss.
We need to.
Yep.
We need
and
that
so
win.
We need that win confidence-wise. I don't know if it'll change the standings any, but we definitely need to.
It'll help us not get in fourth place.
Right.
I mean, it could help us get into the 2 spot, but maybe not, probably not. But it can keep us in the 3rd and not falling behind Cash for the 4th.
Right.
So every district game from here on out, I mean, it's huge.
They all matter.
Yeah, because we don't want to go play it by a district if we don't have to.
Right. Well, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys tomorrow. Have a great evening.
Thank you for tuning in to this presentation of Elk City Athletics, presented by the Bank of Western Oklahoma, where people come first. Big Elk TV and Cool 94 are a part of the Paragon Communications Network, and any distribution or rebroadcast without permission is strictly prohibited. Paragon Communications is owned and operated by Blake Brewer. General Manager is Gabe Edney. Sports Director, Sean Wilson. Once again, thank you for tuning in. Until next time, go Big Elks.